MrExcel from MrExcel Podcast, episode 2388, IF, based on word count. Hey, welcome back to the MrExcel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question from Nas. The sport name has a column of sport names. If the sport name is a single word, we need the left four characters of the sport name. But if it's two words, such as ice hockey or auto racing, then the first three letters of the first word and the first letter of the second word, like ice H or A-U-T-R. And then the thing that just makes me bristle, you must use the if function. Why? Why must we use the if function? Who is this? Is this your manager? Is this a professor? Is this homework? What's going on? All right, so I'm going to ignore that if requirement right now because I think that's a bad way to go using if. What I'm going to do is I'm going to assume always that there's two words. So the equal left of the first word, comma three. And then ampersand and the mid of A8, comma. Where do I want to start? I want to start right after the space. So find a space in A8 plus one for a length of one, like that. And I'm going to get a value error whenever there's a single word, right? Simple enough, but that's okay, because I'm going to handle that value error by wrapping the whole thing in the if error function, right? So if there's not two words, then we know that we're going to be out here and we're just going to simply ask for the left of A8, comma, four, like that. Double click and copy that down. His example, it was uppercase, so maybe wrap the whole thing in upper. I don't know if that's a requirement or not. All right, so beer pong, B-E-E-P. Works great. Now, why is this requirement for using the if function? But if we really have to use the if function, I guess we could do it. We could say equal if the length of A8 is equal to the length of A8 minus any spaces, that'll tell you how many words there are. Then we take the left of A8 comma four. Otherwise, the same formula I just used, essentially. The formula is a lot longer. And I don't particularly like it because it's going to fail when someone does this. If they type soccer, space, 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 then we're not going to get the fourth letter because it finds that space, right? So this is a case where not using if actually is better than using if. And I wonder, you know, why the professor or manager had this requirement of how to use the if function. Maybe they were trying to prevent someone from, well, first just typing the whole thing, or using flash fill. Now, the great way to use flash fill, I took field hockey, something with two words, and moved it up here to the top, F-I-E-H, and then beer pong, and then baseball. So in my examples, I give it enough examples to show it what the rules are, and then back here, data, out on the far right side here, flash fill, or just Control E, press Control E, and it does the right thing. There you are. All right, so Naz, that's my way to do it. Check out my book, MrExcel 2020, Seeing Excel Clearly. If you like these videos, please down below, like, subscribe, and ring that bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast, MrExcel.